Hi, I'm Wade Wingler with the Indata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana. Today, we're going to see a classic computer access accommodation. It's a keyguard. Mark Stewart's going to take us there.
Hi, everybody. Today, we're going to be talking about keyguards a little bit. And I want to try to put an emphasis on giving you a really good view of them and some of the subtleties of how thick they are and how they're placed over the keys and things along those lines. I'm sure a lot of folks associated with assistive technology have at least heard of keyguards, but you might be in a field where you don't use them day in, day out, and where you've seen them is just on a website with a couple pictures, what have you. So hopefully the viewing experience will be a little bit better here. Keyguards, and we're not looking at one yet, I'm going to bring it in. Keyguards are a help for lots of different folks who may have dexterity issues, be it tremor, be it resolution, be it range type issues. When those types of things get to be more severe and they're having a lot of difficulty targeting keys, then the key guard sometimes can really help out. And I think the picture will kind of speak to that a little bit. Part of the point here and part of what you'll be seeing are the limitations to it. It's really one of those things where there is a downside and an upside, and you only want to bring it in when it's going to be definitely helping the person, helping with overall accuracy and efficiency. So what we have here is just happens to be an Easy C keyboard that does have some benefits, larger letters and what have you. But there's a custom key guard for it, and it's important that key guard is specifically for that keyboard. Most of them are see-through acrylic. Edges are not rough, but usually they're not rounded too much. It actually helps with the tactile experience a little bit, being able to feel where you are. So that key guard, again, should be custom made specifically for that keyboard. And they do usually Velcro on, so you can take them off. Sometimes the strategy is to use them sometimes and then take them off if you're having good days or bad days. The good days you might not use the key guard, and then other days you might put it on. Notice how, even though this is custom made for this keyboard, the key guard is raised quite a bit above the keyboard. It really has a limiting effect too. So see how if you don't need it, it will slow you down, okay? But I think you also see that if you do need it, it's gonna really help guide you, it's gonna help you from making mistakes. So a hand could be rested right on it. I'm not depressing any keys right now. It's gonna really help guide me into a specific place that I'm going, and I'm also getting a lot of extra tactile sensory feedback as I do that. But again, kind of note the trade-off. Note how it would help certain types of folks and not other folks. Here's just another more generic keyboard with a custom key guard. Actually, this one has slipped down some. You need to be careful about that, about the placement. There's a keyboard we use a lot that's called the Big Keys LX. I didn't have it available today, but the keys are larger, and it also has a custom key guard for it. So that keyboard, the Big Keys LX with the key guard, is a keyboard that's very forgiving for folks. And again, I thought it might just be interesting for people to really have a nice view of it so that they can think through their own cases and situations. Sometimes a keyboard cover gets confused for a key guard. A keyboard cover is not a key guard. Key guard, keyboard cover. Keyboard covers are used often for industrial environments to keep out dust and protect the keyboard from liquids and dirt and things like that. This one actually has a dual purpose. It's a really neat concept. You can take a regular keyboard, put this keyboard cover over it, and it has letters that are more viewable to certain folks with low vision challenges, and also, as you've already seen, larger letters that are more easily viewed for a lot of folks as well. Keyboard cover, Keyguard. I hope that helps. Have a great day.
So there's a great way to avoid issues with a keyboard if you have tremors or other difficulties with your hands. That's your tech tip for this week. I'm Wade Wingler with the Endata Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.